Good. So, in this session, we are going to discuss something about how to write research proposals, research papers with reference to ecology, biodiversity, and climate change. The topic is very important because most of the funding agencies, including government and non-government organizations, they are looking for some unique, innovative, vertical thinking proposals to fund. Yeah, the topic is important because most of the developed countries and international funding agencies are organizing seminars and workshops to develop skills in the following aspects. Number one, identifying and defining a specific research topic for personal research. What do you mean by personal research? Personal research means most of the research institutes, institutional research agenda will be there. In addition, most of the research personalities, they used to take their own problem for their research. The developing research questions to direct ensuing research, organizing the research materials in a format to write successful research proposal to funding agencies, writing research papers for impact factor journals. These are the routine topics in most of the developed countries. Countries like India, we have some many unique programs recently initiated by various ministries. There is a program called STARS. What we have, this program is called STRIDE, and there was a project in CERB, high-risk, high-reward project, and recently they are asking the proposals need to be vertical nature, not to publish papers, not only to attend conferences or seminar papers. They are looking for something new. So nowadays, most of the funding agencies are asking three important aspects. One is multidisciplinary research. The second one is vertical thinking. The third one is out-of-box thinking. So if you search in the internet, it will be telling you it's something new. Not audible, children. I think you check your internet. It's here. It's clear for other participants. Maithili, you can check your internet connection. Fine. So now any proposal we need to have you need to have three important aspects. So our thinking need to be clear, that to be new, innovative, critical, and so on. So if you search all these words in internet, it will be telling you something new. That is it. But that is not correct. Multidisciplinary research, it's the most common word nowadays you can hear. That is to incorporate many disciplines to solve one problem. So we also tried incorporating mathematical sciences into ecology. We got a couple of projects. One is bioinvasion, marine bioinvasion, and mathematical modeling in Gulf of Mannar. And another project related to modeling in the same Gulf of Mannar ecosystem services and so on. But actually, major breakthroughs not happened. So real multidisciplinary research, young researchers like you can take forward. And those research questions and the research problems can be addressed through various disciplines that is called multidisciplinary. Then the STRIDE scheme, like STRIDE, it is what you can say, transdisciplinary. There is no border. Multidisciplinary, beyond multidisciplinary. So you have to think vertically. In this session, I'm going to share some of our experience and literature collected from various sources. Going to share how to design successful research problems, approaching the funding agency, preparation of research papers for journals, creating awareness about the importance of innovative research. These are the major objective of this lecture. So if you have any questions at any point of time, you can stop and we can interact. This is going to be not a lecture. I want this session need to be interactive. At any point, you can just use the chat box and you can stop at any point of time. For any successful research project, we need to have three important aspects. Everyone will be having some research idea. The research idea, if you have some research idea, you have to ask three questions. Whether the research idea is worthwhile. If worthwhile, whether it is feasible. Feasible, then whether this research idea is original. So, if you answer these three questions, then your research idea will take the next step. So, while designing or developing the research idea, now people are asking, what is the use? What is the use of funding this project? So, we have to give importance. Either we are going to document the rare species that exist in the Western Ghats of Tamil Nadu. No, if not, then we are going to find a novel molecule that can be used for treatment of any particular disease. No, if not, we are going to conserve the endemic species that is with national importance, then your research idea or research problem will be definitely supported by funding agencies. There are many people ready to fund the project. Only we have to make it, or we cannot blame anyone. So we have to develop the project in a manner may not be denied at any stage. So nowadays, including my students or children or myself, any question we are not asking ourselves. We are immediately going to Google or Yahoo or any search engine and asking what is what. Before asking, you ask yourself. There are some many factual findings definitely easily we can get from the what you can say from the search engines. But you have to have some idea about the topic you ask yourself. Then you start writing also. Nowadays people are everything refer something and taking previously there was a culture called copy and paste culture. Control C and Control V. Now people are doing copy, paste, edit culture. So now easily the copy and paste was detected through many softwares, plagiarism checker. Now people are using that another option called edit. File click, left click, find something, find synonyms and replace. So you please don't use those tools unnecessarily. So you take your problem and write, start writing. The very purpose of this session's lecture is all you have to submit the Sunday in this project in the program. We gave assignment. Assignment is not going to be taking something from internet and writing something. That is not going to be the assignment for you. So really I want to make this program as a capacity building program. Some of you may be having a previous experience also, no problem. Again you try with another pair of spectacles. I will tell you, you start writing. There are many type of articles we can write to journals. Research articles are there. You can write review articles. You can write opinion. You can write commentary. You can write news and reviews. So there are every scope for you to write for the science people. There are many journals. There are, you may not believe it. Per month, we are across the globe, we are publishing more than 1 lakh research articles. So it shows that almost everyone is writing. I don't know how many of you used to read Professor Balram's editorials when he was the editor of Current Science. You have time if you go and read the editorials written by Professor Balram. Almost he touched every aspect of science related issues. The way he wrote, the way he presents the things are going to be amazing. All young researchers, we have to read those editorials. It's available free in the Current Science website. Once he wrote about the writing research papers, he cited some author. And the cited author wrote that humans are animals that can write letters. Then he modified and he wrote, Professor Balram wrote, now people are writing papers, not letters. So everyone is writing. There are lakhs of papers are being published every day. Then actually you may not believe 77% of the papers never read other than the reviewer and the author. That indicates what? Not useful to most of the people. So I am requesting you take the current topic and write. So your opinion you can write. So your commentary you can write. So if the journal if your article is general, you go for science, you go for nature, you go for current science. Subject specific, climate change science is there, ecological economics is there. There are many journals. So only thing is we need to have innovative idea. Now every journal is asking. Most of the time if I submit the paper from the lab before reaching my home, around 20 kilometers, I will be receiving the mail from the editorial office by saying that your paper is not having any innovative ideas. Therefore, we are sorry to say that, we are regret to inform you that your article is not recommended for further screening. Even most of the papers submitted nowadays are not being scrutinized by the subject experts. Even it was rejected in the at the stage of actually in the editorial office itself. So now this is the time to think innovatively, think critically, and approach the problem through out of box thinking. So this is I used to write the things. Here you can see in the screen biodiversity hotspot, defining the indefinable. That is the title. Actually, that was published I think 2007. At the time, the biodiversity hotspot concept was so, what you can say, it was discussed as a silver bullet strategy to conserve the biodiversity across the world. But my thought is different from that. So I don't want to keep the alternative thought with me. So we wrote that is in India, we have two biodiversity hotspots. One is Western Ghats, another one is Eastern Himalaya. But actually more than 40 crore people are depend on not Eastern Himalaya, Western Himalaya. You conserve Eastern Himalaya, but at the same time, we have to give importance to Western Himalaya. So biodiversity, we cannot define hotspot, cool spot, or whatever the terminology may be, but we have to conserve every aspect of life. That is my opinion. I am not insisting you. I am not insisting to my students, but my opinion, I wrote to Current Science. It was published. Okay. This is another article. The title is Linnaeus 300 Tips for Tinkering Morphological Taxonomy. If you read this paper, we summarized the issues currently what we have in the taxonomic research in India. But we wrote very earlier, I communicated when the world celebrating Linnaeus, Carl Linnaeus 300 birthday. So such a way you have to be, you have to plan your research activity well in advance, systematic approach, consistent manner, then definitely your research career will be very bright and useful to the society also. So this is another article. So now most of the rejected papers we are publishing in national conferences, national or international or state level conferences, we are publishing all the elite data with important data. We are first sending it to some impact factor 7 journals, then slowly to 3 impact factor 1, if not finally to the national level or international conferences. Actually, the conferences are arranged to discuss very important topics. But when the my experience is, most of the time we are organizing the seminars, symposia at national level or international level, many times immature science areas. Most of the research activity may not be there in particular subject. Even then we used to conduct. So the research, the keynote speaker, the presenter, everyone is taking from the material the same internet. So then I got some, what you can say, this is not correct way. So to express my view, another article we wrote, our national level conferences, end of season sales, reduction sale manner, we are publishing, we are discussing the science issues. That's what the content of that paper. So now we come to the point. Any research paper or proposal will be having introduction. Some funding agencies or the people may ask you to write a review of literature. Another terminology for the same is going to be work done in India and abroad. national and international status, all are going to refer only to the previous literature. What already done in that particular topic is the main focused area for the second point. Then we need to have a statement of problem, objectives, then key hypotheses and questions need to be addressed. Significant or agency going to utilize your product or method, then methods, results, discussion, summary, abstract. These are the main major component for any research proposal or paper. If the research proposal, we may not have results under discussion. Instead of summary, we used to have abstract. Otherwise, everything is going to be the same. So now we are going to today, we are going to discuss one by one. So what is introduction? So we used to introduce the morning from the first session onwards, I am doing the same thing, introducing the speaker to you. I'm telling you, all important points, sir. Professor Rambuj is a former UNESCO chair. He served more than 40 years in environmental education. So he handled many projects. He published important research articles in the field of ecology. Everything I'm telling, all are to receive your attention. If you are attentive to receive your attention, I am telling all these points. Similarly, your research problem also need to have attractive introduction. It need to provide background information for research proposal or research paper. It should create interest to the reviewer also. Don't think all the reviewers are knowing all your research topics. I will tell you, any task force, any review panel may be having not more than 10 experts. I am ecologist. I am working in ecology since 1993 onwards. Ecology is another general topic. I cannot handle all the ecological problems. My area of specialization only restricted to biological invasion. Not even biological invasion, mine is more specialized to plant invasions. So I cannot review all the research proposals related to ecology. Even animal ecology, I am not the competent enough to review. Okay, so you don't think the reviewer have idea about your proposal, then your proposal need to be designed in such a way, starting from the beginning. Sir, the binomial nomenclature was proposed by Carl Linnaeus about 200 years back. It was further reviewed, revised, modified, edited. All those things you have to give reference. Finally, what you are going to do. So, from the beginning, you cannot start in between. But at the same time, you should not write all the histories. One person, he was senior to me in the college. So, I was working as assistant professor at the time. He came. He told me, I came here to attend the interview. So you, since you are working here, what are the expected questions you tell me? That's what he asked. I told him, first they will ask you to introduce yourself. I told him, you introduce yourself, then they will be asking questions based on your introduction. Then you may not believe, they gave 10 minutes time to him. He started, sir, I was born in a small village called Kattapatti in 7:30 p.m. at one day. I started my school at the age of four. I studied my Panchayat Union school up to fifth standard. Fifth standard, I got 80% mark. Before coming to the college, in the 10 minutes was over. The interview also over. He was not given the job also. So you have to know which is the important point for introduction. So yesterday I told you, Professor Rambuj was 40 years experience. If I started reading all his contribution, it will take another 1 hour to tell all his achievements in a lecture. So what I am trying to tell is, the introduction need to be well written and need to receive the attention of the reviewers. A couple of weeks back, we submitted a paper to a journal. It was rejected because not for the lack of results, the your introduction not giving the novelty of the paper. So such a way now people are reviewing. The time has changed. When I was the student, we used to send the mail to Netherlands to publish in Elsevier journals, forest ecology and management, agriculture, ecosystem and environment. The postage, still I have a memory, we have to pay 200 rupees as postage. So then they will receive, they review and they will send back. Now, now the the time has changed. Everything is in your fingertip. So all your introductions need to be, this is, before that I will tell you, I started my first research project in 2005 with an outlay of 50,000 rupees. That is, you may not believe, that is, I want to buy a laptop for my research. At the time, laptop cost around 40,000-50,000. My salary is only 13,000 at the time. So there is no other way other than approaching the funding agency. So I was so happy. They sanctioned the project. After opening the letter, I found that they took away what you can say the computer component, and they sanctioned only the rest, another 50,000. So then I didn't leave. Then Department of Biotechnology called for some program. It's called Bioresources Management Training Program. So I submitted a proposal. So at the time, I think they have selected 25 or 26 proposals out of 200 proposals. Amazingly, my proposal also selected. By the time I was in a college at the time, they gave me 5 lakh rupees. So immediately I purchased the computer, that is a laptop, IBM. Then I purchased a printer, successfully conducted the program also. So that was my first project. I started my career from there. In another 5 years, in 2010, I got 10 crores from MHRD project. Since I moved from my previous college to Madurai Kamaraj University, then I left the project there and I came here. I'm telling all this because if we have a passion towards research, particularly ecological research, nowadays people are ready to fund. Only we need to equip ourselves. So don't omit any of your research idea. Research idea will not, you cannot get any research idea from the internet. You can get the information only. Idea is going to come out. So we all are loving nature. Along the roadside, you can find any number of research problems. I will tell you one simple observation, how it paid to me and my lab in terms of project and paper and laurels in the later section of this session. So we wrote like this. We know many fathers in different branches of biology, but Linnaeus is the grandfather. Nobody coined the grandfather in science. So far only fathers are there. we wrote like that. The whole conceptual foundation of taxonomy is solely the product of his intellectual labor. This is we've taken from our current science paper. So broad foundation for the problem that leads to the study that we need to mention. What is the broad problem? When I used to when in 2000 up to 2010, most of the time when visiting Delhi for a proposal presentation or review meeting, we used to go only by train. So it will take two nights and one day to reach Delhi from Chennai. So after that, we are flying by using aircraft. So when I was traveling in a train, a fellow colleague in Tamil Nadu Express, he used to ask, "Sir, you are from Tamil Nadu? I started from Delhi." "Yes, sir, I am from Tamil Nadu." "So Tamil Nadu, which city, sir?" "Sir, I am belonging to Madurai." "Sir, I also Madurai only, sir. Madurai is which area, sir?" "So I am belonging to some local place. I am telling Madurai Kamaraj University, I study." So any introduction start from like Tamil Nadu, a broad foundation. So then coming down narrow to the specific point. Then the introduction of the research proposal also need to be there like that only. Starting from broad, the work done, where is the gap? Then finally, where I am going to work this problem in Western Ghats of Tamil Nadu. So that is the way you have to write the introduction. For example, the present investigation aims to document the consequences of perturbation on the composition and structure of herbaceous community on a range of natural and man-impacted ecosystem in Western Ghats. So we started documentation, consequence, further we are gradually coming to Western Ghats. So any research introduction need to be in a summary, I can say, it need to receive attention from the reviewers. At the same time, you have to specifically start from broad foundation and slowly coming to narrow down your objective and complete your introduction. So then what is review of literature? Review of literature, that is to whether you know the writer is knowledgeable about the area. It relates a study to larger ongoing dialogue in the literature about the topic. It provides the framework for establishing the importance of the study, as well as benchmark for comparing the result of a study with other findings. So here we have to avoid some statements. The little has been done. Two extensive studies already available. Don't use those kind of terminologies. So refer only research papers from standard refereed research journals. If you type your keyword, immediately appearing papers may not be the correct ones. So you have to read, you have to check the authenticity and update the literature with recent publications. When I was reviewing a thesis, I asked one person why there are many references are missing. That person, the scholar, replied to me, "Sir, people were telling that 10 references are enough." That is not correct. 10 references you can use for your study, but using many references and leaving most of them uncited and taking only 10 is misunderstood the concept. Okay, so the review of literature also very important. So when we are talking about biological innovation, any project related to bioinnovation, I cannot leave Yelton. Yelton is the first person, he proposed the concept of biological innovation. Then I have to say something about the contributions of Charles Yelton before starting the problem. So that means I know I'm working in a particular topic, what are the important milestones, and also can be easily, we can understand. So one day, one of my friend, he called me and said, "Sir, Chan sir, tell me whether this is Simbo Bogan grass." So then I told him, "This is not the Simbo Bogan. So I will show you the Simbo Bogan grass in the computer." I typed Simbo Bogan. The first picture appeared in the net is the photograph what shown by my colleague from a M.Phil dissertation. The photograph also labeled as Simbo Bogan. Similar, the same name also posted in the photograph also. So I request you, don't refer the images of websites as a key to identify the species. So we know anybody can post their own ideas in the internet. So they need not be correct also. Check the scientific authenticity of the material, that is publisher, who is publishing, whether it is published by Botanical Survey of India or Zoological Survey of India or Kew Botanical Garden and so on. So when I was writing the first proposal, the question is origin of the proposal. I was wondering at the time, what do you mean by origin of proposal? These people always taught only origin of species. How proposal, what is the meaning of origin of proposal? I was so hesitant to ask someone after completing PhD, even this fellow, they may comment, this fellow even doesn't know what is origin of proposal, what he is going to do. So then I was looking on the internet. So then finally I found that, so we need to take lectures, our experience to the young researchers, the terminology used in research proposals or papers. So based on that idea only, this lecture, I used to regularly deliver this lecture in most of the college teachers to take up the projects. Okay. So the statement, then the origin of proposal or statement of the problem is, what makes the researcher to understand this project? Example, excuse me. Sorry for the so what makes the research to undertake? I used to tell the project, the objective of project to my daughter or to my son. Sometimes they used to go in between. That means, since I'm an ecologist, ecology is a common man science. Anybody can understand whether what is the significance and so on. So then we need to convince everyone whether the problem is worthwhile. Easily we can understand. So here taken from a project we received from UGC about coral reefs. Coral reefs occupy less than 1% of Earth's marine environment, but home to more than quarter of all known marine life species and tens of thousands of other species found nowhere in the earth. They provide important ecosystem services by protecting coastal areas, mitigating effects of tsunami. However, most part of the ecosystem services provided by corals are not recognized. So in this context, studying the ecosystem services of coral reefs are important. So such a way, what makes undertake this project or this problem? That is more important. That is the key aspect of any proposal. The issues that exist in the literature that lead to the study, actually obscure or poorly formulated problems or mask the original thought of the researcher. If a researcher is unable to answer this question, the question is, what for you are taking this project? No, sir, I want to publish a paper on this. You may not get the project. So it need to have a real need for that particular project. So the next component is the purpose of the study. The purpose of the statement should provide specific and accurate synopsis of the overall purpose of the study. Try to incorporate the sentence that begins with the purpose of the study is. For example, the purpose of the proposed study is to analyze the impact of Ipomoea carnea on ecosystem services of native communities in and around Madurai, South India. The purpose is not clear to the writer, it cannot be clear to the reviewer. So you have to be clear first, then only you can clear the idea, the minds of the reviewers. The questions are hypotheses. Always we need not have hypotheses, but we need to have research questions. A research question poses a relationship between two or more variables, but phrases the relationship as a question. Hypotheses represent a declaration statement of the relation between two or more variables. Use questions or hypotheses based on the purpose of the study. For example, whether the biological invasion alters the structure and functional attributes of native community. That is going to be the one research question in a project related to a biological invasion. So here we need to be very clear. What is our research question? So you think first the introduction need to be there. Every, for your kind information, I am telling you, every paper or project need to be like a script. It need to be like a script. So every sentence you need to give attention. So and if the introduction itself, you are going to define, I am going to do this job for this purpose. Then you are taking the same idea to another section also. That is the purpose. The statement of the problem also, it need to reflect. Don't say the same thing in different way, but the same message. The questions, hypothesis also need to reflect the same. Goals and objectives. So most of the time goals are not going to be there for short term projects, but long term projects you need to have the goals also. It comes typically after problem definition, starts with overall objective and then state 2 to 4 specific objectives. Sometimes when I was young, starting stage, used to put many objectives, 6, 7, 8. But the reviewer used to ask, cut down the objectives. So in a typical 3-year project with OMJRF and some contingency and travel grant, with a few lakhs of equipment, you can address only maximum 4 research objectives. Putting too many objectives, going to may not be a good for the projects. So goal is different from objective. You see, example for a goal, to provide communities and tools and information they to attain sustainable self-sufficiency in an increasing industrialized world, retaining the cultural framework. You cannot do this. It's the goal. My goal is to provide tools and information to overcome the climate change. That is my goal. That goal won't help you. So if you are an applicant for any central university as a assistant professor, associate professor, or professor, they will be asking two things. One is your teaching philosophy. What is teaching philosophy? Teaching philosophy, that is nothing but why you want to become a teacher. Okay. The next question is, what is your vision, mission statement for this university? Even if I am applying for a vice chancellorship, they are going to ask me, what is your vision, mission for the university? The vision, eradicating poverty from India is going to be vision. Mission, there are many schemes, strategies, that is implementation. So these three are entirely different. Vision, mission, that is to accomplish, the strategies to achieve. So the goal is common, broad category. Then we have to come to the objectives to fulfill the goals. So you can see, to study the impact of exotic organisms on structure and composition of phytoplankton, zooplankton and fish population in selected study site in the Gulf of Mannar. That is one objective. To assess the impact of exotics on ecosystem level process, another objective. To use molecular techniques to identify geographic origin of invasive species, that is another objective. So objectives, a goal is going to be broad, objectives are going to be specific. So this is going to be very important component. This is the heart of the research proposal. Now, if you are a researcher applying for the project in any funding agency, they will be asking you one page. Now, everywhere in the word restrictions are there. Tell your problem in 100 words. Write your objectives in bullet points, not more than 500 characters. The methodology alone, they used to give you 4 pages. All other things are restricted. Words are by character. So, detailed methodology with reference we need to give. So, we need to be careful. What are the facilities available with us? What are the equipment, sensitivity? We need to be very, very careful. So most of the time, the statistics is going, most of the biologists are some kind of phobic towards statistics numbers. So nowadays, there are many statistical softwares are available. You can see free software also, paid software also. Many institutions having their own licensed software. So if you enter some number, it will give you some numbers, but that may not help you. So if time permits, I will take you one statistics session. So learn the theoretical part of the statistics before applying it to research. Use appropriate statistics. Where to use a t-test, where to use non-parametric test, what is parametric test, where to use Wilkinson test, where to use ANOVA. We need to have a theoretical knowledge. Then only we can go for the analysis. Enhance the interpretation of statistical results. Hands-on training with statistical packages are always advisable. The summary. This is the last thing you write, and it is very well written. The research problem and its significance, methods, details the variable and parameters to be measured, how the data will be analyzed, likely outcomes, applicability and relevance also you need to give, how your proposed research fit with regional or national priorities or strategies. So, when I was a student of Professor Chidambaram Swamy, way back to 1993, so he asked me to write the proposal for my PhD registration. Then I wrote something. I took help from my neighboring lab senior colleagues, and they gave their registration copy. And I based on that, with a few mistakes, and I wrote and I gave it to my professor. My professor told that, no, this is story. He didn't read also. He just so like this. So then again I took some other's help and rewritten, again submitted. That time also he told, no, this is not a way of writing. So you may not believe, after 24th time, 2 months, so he told me how to write the synopsis. So he told, these three questions if you address, then your summary will come. What you did, what you got, why you got, and add one sentence for your recommendation or future direction of research. So I was wondering why this professor was not telling this grammar in the first itself. But they are the teachers. They forced us to learn. So do not put too many objectives, I told you. Don't propose well-established research problem. Don't assume the reviewer know the problem you are addressing. Don't use it is well known or it is obvious. So when I was writing the papers in early 2000, we used to over enthusiastically put, we are first reporting. I am the first person reporting this. Our finding is the first. So then only the reviewer repeatedly advised us, don't use this. So you tell your point, the people will say who said first. So you need not worry about whether you are first or second. So then we stop writing, the over enthusiasm has gone. So we settled in the ground state, and now we are writing what we are observing. So every research lab need to have some secret weapons. This is more important. So you have to build your team first, or you have to join in a team. So in our team, I will introduce you maybe in next couple of days. So we have a comprehensive team. A person who will write the proposal. Another person is there. He will be working on statistics. Another person is there. He knows English. All the four, they used to visit the field together. Everyone is collecting their own specimen and their own research, addressing their own research problems. So another person is there, he is working on all our artificial intelligence models. As a botanist, I don't know anything about artificial intelligence, but we have a couple of projects on artificial intelligence. And the theoretical part we may be knowing, but the technical part, some other person, he is going to deliver you a lecture on the use of artificial intelligence in climate change research, maybe after 24th or 25th. So we need to have a team, particularly a discipline like climate science or ecology or biodiversity. So one, we cannot contribute anything to the betterment. So our secret weapon, so special equipment, maybe the secret weapon, your experience, unique strength and insights, anything may be your weapon. So after writing your paper or project, double check the spelling, the format, citation requirement, and give it to a learned expert for revision, and see the rationale described and its significance, share your view, revise the proposal, and don't take granted. Even I'm going to complete my 50 years and almost 20 years service in ecology. Even now I'm checking all these. Whatever the effort we put, it will pay for us. If you are very lethargic and overconfident, even the failure will happen to even at the level of professor. So I'm telling you, these will definitely, I feel, will help you to write some problem. So based on this, I am requesting you. Now, this is the second day. Our program is only 10 days. So 2 days over. Now you have some idea about climate change, about the happenings, and so on. So now, after this lecture, you try to find a research problem as your own and write the proposal. Monday, you submit the same for review. At the end, all the participants, all the 30 participants, need to submit a proposal. If it is worthwhile, definitely we will take it forward. Take further, either through internship or through the technical, the exchange program, and so on. So, at least the capacity building need to be developed. I need to have some confidence. I am putting all my effort to conduct this program. The government of India is giving money from the taxpayers' money, so I am answerable to that. I need to first convince myself. Yes. All the 30 participants. Now, you definitely, few of me already have the ability. But I need to have my own satisfaction by saying that all the 31 participants now have the capacity to write the research proposal that I want to see. So, the research is the long-term project. All you are young researchers, identify the problem. The problem at least for next 10 years based on the meeting reports. So most of the time we never read, specifically typing few keywords and taking the particular paper and read and okay, that is it. So try to read the editorials of various journals, particularly Science, Nature, Current Science. You read the editorials. Then you can find where the science is, the direction where the science is going. I don't know how many of you regularly read all these editorials. Then meeting reports also you have to find. Journal opinion column articles also you need to break out. Hello, it's audible, Vijay?
Yes sir,
No
continue
problem.
पढ़ना
Okay. So, do the basic research in the emerging areas should be carried out without major fund. So, to audience, okay. So, it is now, excuse me. Now, before I cannot go and ask, sir, give me 1 crore rupee. I want to take up a project on climate change. So, you write something about climate change. So, you observe there are many trees around you. You mark this year, or you record all the phenological events. There are at the maximum 8 to 10 phenological behaviors you can see in any tree. Leaf initiation, leaf maturation, leaf fall, flower initiation, flower maturation, fruit initiation, fruit maturation, fruit dispersal. If you record regularly these events 2, 3 years, your research paper definitely will go to not for Science or Nature, definitely it will go for a good journal if you combine with the pollinator and fruit dispersal. So we have to be, if you read the literature, there are even just you read the life history of Darwin. Darwin's Darwin, when he was in Cambridge, he used to collect the beetles, and he used to, his hobby, that is, he used to identify the beetle and without killing it, he used to release it to again the same place. At the time, he was looking for some variations. He found one insect and he caught it in the right hand. Another also, he, after few steps, he got another, the right hand he hold. So, unfortunately, he found the third specimen also. So, what that fellow he did, he put the right hand insect into his mouth and finally he caught the third one. The insect, not knowing whether Darwin or Linnaeus, the bite experienced by the Darwin forced him to leave all the three insects. His dunk was blocked for many years. So that kind of, what you can say, dedication, involvement we need to have in science. Then only we can see science as a fascinating one. So after publishing few things, you approach funding agencies. So this definitely will help you to achieve the goal. So currently we are working on artificial intelligence for the ICMR sponsored project. ICMR immediately, without any publication, they won't give. They have to justify how a botanist, that is also an ecologist, going to work on AI. So that kind of, anyway, now you may be knowing artificial intelligence is very frequently used terminology in all fields. So we also need to cope up. One research paper will take you somewhere. This is the paper we published in way back to 2008 in Current Science, Bioinvasion of Capophagus alvarezii on corals in the Gulf of Mannar, India. So I published more than 25-30 articles before publishing this article. But I never thought giving the correspondence email, because no response from nobody across the world after publishing many papers. After publishing this paper, you may not believe, my mailbox was full always. Every day I need to answer too many people. So even then we published this. So the next issue of Science and Nature, both of the journals, they wrote about one page article about our article, the Seaweed Invader Elites Against India, that was the Science journal's title. The Nature also, the Indian coral island under threat from sea alga, that also written in Nature. These all are, I will tell you in the morning, Professor Nagarathnam was telling you about journalism. So these are scientific journals. They are looking for good journalists, those who know the science. So a government prohibited alien seaweed cultivation based on our recommendation. The seaweed was removed from the site and I was satisfied. Our result, our the pain at least have some impact on the system. So now I think around 4:30 time, so we can stop here. Any research questions, I'm ready to answer. Swapna Echmalan. Swapna is asking, sir, how do you choose right journal for any science article or paper? And what is, good. Now, in general, nowadays we have many journals. Some of them are not familiar with us. Repeatedly, we are competing for only the selected few journals. And that too, the rejection rate is going to be very high, journals, the traditional journals we used to approach. Nowadays, Springer and elsewhere, they have their own software to paste your abstract. We will tell you which of our journal is more suitable for you. That is one way, but another way is we can based on the data strength, we can choose the journal. Some of the journals, they will be looking for huge data. Years together, we have to provide, particularly ecology, biodiversity, conservation, or climate change is concerned. Some of the journals, they are unique. I told you, I will tell you, there is one journal called the Coral Reef. One section in Coral Reef, that section is only one page, reef sites. The section is reef sites. There, the total length of the paper only 450 words with two displays. That is need to be new. So there they don't require much data. They are asking you to submit a novel. So based on the data strength, discovery, invention, and whether new, there are now you have to spend a lot of time to find the suitable journal. If you are selecting suitable journal, your 50% journey is over. Or otherwise, they are going to repeatedly saying that your work is not novel, your data is insufficient, you are jumping to conclusion and those kind of things. They used to, nowadays, the open access hybrid policy has emerged. Now, after rejecting one paper, and you will be receiving from the editor's office, sir, we are supporting you to transfer your article to this journal. You have to pay only just $1,758 only. So this kind of mails also we are receiving. But this is a time we have to think innovatively. Routine papers, it's not going well now. So every time thinking innovatively also, it's very difficult. Even then, there is no other option. We are moving towards that kind of that phase. Publication fee is some high impact, but general. Yeah, this is, yeah. So it's going to be very, I think we are planning to write to our ministry, Atmanirbharat need to be initiated from the publication of Indian science research. So I think we will, that will happen. So, yeah. Sir, can you do individual project without being any kind of organization and still get funds? Yeah. Maitri, it's a good question. There are many funding agencies. They are supporting for the individual research also. So you can have the small grants instead of going for lakhs or crores. You can have a small project. Definitely, there are many agencies are there now. They are giving funding. They are not looking for any affiliation. Morning, Professor Naradhanam, he took now. Most of the programs, except one or two, all these programs supported by various non-government funding agencies. Definitely, there are many possibility to take up freelancing research. Yeah. Any other? Any other questions? Sir, what is the approach for receiving grants? Yeah. So I told you the Shubham Bavar is asking, sir, what is the approach for receiving grants? Yeah, now there are two major sources. One is government source, another one is non-government agencies. Nowadays, even government agencies are looking for new innovative projects, even starting from Niti Aayog also now supporting. From Niti Aayog to MHRD, there are many agencies to support the research grant. So, we will, any specific requirement, we will, you can contact the specific, based on the objectives, we can go. Why do we have the care list journals? Actually, do we need such monitoring process? Muralidharan is asking, why do we have the care list journals? Actually, do we need such monitoring process? Yeah, it's a very fantastic question. Actually, what happened? So we try to, we ecologists, we know many data is qualitative data. We in the government of India at one point of time want to convert the quality data into quantity data. The research they want to quantify. So then they put how many PhDs you have produced, how many papers you published, then immediately one, you may not believe, one person, he came to attend a JRF interview, one of our projects. I asked him, what you are doing currently now? He told that I am editing a journal, sir. I was wondered how a person just after completing master's, he is editing. What will you what you are doing? That was I asked him. He told that, sir, someone will be sending the paper, sir. We are, after charging the money, we send it to the typesetter and they will be printing it, sir. So then there was no other option to have some regulatory mechanism to oversee the journal quality. For that, now UGC introduced. I don't know how much time this is going to be there, and what is, still people are working to make the process realistic. So we will see what will happen in future. Sir, would you like to know regarding choosing referees for our paper review? Focus on what criteria we should be referring. Yeah, sir, we can give both the need to be referee, not to be refereed also. We can give now most of the journals. There are many things happening around us. So people are doing the review by their own team members. If they ask foreign reviewer also, they used to give their old colleagues, and they are using their own mechanism. Even then, we used to, in our lab, we are practicing, we are giving. The most influential scientists working in the recent past, we used to take the criteria, past 2 years, how many papers he published, and we used to give their name. Definitely, as of my knowledge is concerned, most of the journals, they are only receiving the referee's name, they are sending it to some other's review, not to the name what we are giving, most of the journals, but some journals they are giving using the same reviewer scheme. Yeah. Sir, if the other person is doing the same research work, mine, how can I know? Yeah, Soumya is asking another interesting question. Sir, if the other person has doing the same research work of mine, how can I know it? So, I will tell you our experience. We published a paper, online trade of exotic aesthetic organisms in India. That is our title. The paper we submitted to Current Science. It was published after 5 months. Before coming our paper, the same similar paper was published from Italy, one from Italy, another one from US. They took their data, our data, we took our data, only in the ours is by 1 year because the submitted date is earlier than ours. But you are very correct. The question is very specific. Actually, nowadays we cannot, even our search engine will tell the people so and so is working in this area, and we have to be careful to keep our research work confidential. Otherwise, it easily can be taken by others. Yeah. Sir, is this our assignment to write a paper? Yeah, not a paper. Nisha is asking, sir, is this our assignment to write a paper? Not a paper. You identify any problem you are noticing and make that particular problem into a research proposal. That is the assignment. So now, role of statistics, our research work. Sometimes it has observed that unnecessary statistics, which could not even understandable, were seen in work. Up to which depth we should use complex statistics? It is depend on our collected data, or making it simple or understanding is more important. Yeah. So there are two things. Convenience is not science. My student Inder Saizanian was proposing a new hypothesis on invasion. The flowering phenology is the key for invasion. So to prove his hypothesis, he proved with one side invasive organisms is going to be abundant. To prove that, he took the rare plants. But the referee was not agreeing that the rare plant is different, invasive plant is different. You cannot prove this hypothesis by using the rare plants. So then I was arguing by one page write-up, these are the reasons we want to keep this. So then he wrote only one line, convenience is not science. Okay, fine. If you are using complicated, complex statistics or models, your results will be very simple. You can summarize. Actually, statistics is nothing but numerical summary. So the statistics, sometimes we biologists are not mathematicians. Most of them, and the statistics is going to be mathematics. We are telling that is statistics, but actually that also a branch of mathematics. So we have to go for the modern tools. Now people are using AI. Now big data analysis has come. So even if we want to complete the research paper by 10, 15, 20 samples in future, nobody is going to take up. So there is no other way. So now sometimes it is going to be tedious. Even then there is no other option. You have to use multiple tools and multiple data to bring a comprehensive one-line summary result. If you write a paper to Nature or Science, they are asking the summary in one line. One-line summary, writing one-line summary is going to be more difficult. If you have enough results only, we can write a summary in one line. Maithili, can we publish these unexpected results, negative results in a paper? Or it is? Yeah, now there are many journals. There is one journal started by an Indian. Science matters. It's you can publish single observation, negative results in that journal. I will maybe tomorrow I will tell you the name of the journal. You need not have triplicate. You need not have any statistics. Even unexpected results, the specific purpose of the journal was publishing unexpected results. So I will tell you the journal name tomorrow. It was started by an Indian. Now he is there in Europe. So he is the proprietor of the journal. I will tell you the journal name tomorrow.